we are getting set for action. The coin toss in the middle of the field. Four captains for each team. And the Blue Racers will call the coin, and it looks like the Blue Racers have won the toss. So the Blue Racers, they've deferred. They won the toss and they have deferred to the second half. So the Silverbacks will receive and go left to right on your TV screen and on your computer. Chris Stanford was pressed into action this past week due to the injury to Bruce Jones. He sustained that in Marion a couple of weeks ago, and Bruce is just not ready to go yet. The offense for the Dayton Silverbacks, Fred Cromarty, Marcus Fales, and Melvin Bryant are the, and Daniel Stover are the wide receivers, are the skilled players, along with Chris Stanford. Up front, we'll get the meat of the front line here in just a minute, but right now, Fred Cromarty, and by the way, Fred Cromarty, before the game, told me that the Silverbacks will win tonight and win big. So the Silverbacks are supposed to win tonight, according to Fred Cromarty. Back deep with Cromarty is number 18, Victor Tolbert. Tolbert from Central State. And teeing it up for the Blue Racers is Tyler Lorenz. And we are set for action here at Hara Arena. Sit back and enjoy tonight's game between the Silverbacks and the Blue Racers. And here we go. Kick. Just barely missed the scoreboard. Cromarty has it. He's to the 10. He's to the 15. He's to the 21-man to beat. He's off to the races. He's going to score. 55-yard TD run by Fred Cromarty. And he is living up to his prediction right now. 55 yards for Fred Cromarty. And what a way to start the game tonight. So a 55-yard run, kickoff return from Fred Cromarty, and Jeff Hubbard will kick the extra point for the Silverbacks as clock runs down. What a way to start the game. Snap is up, and the kick is up, and it is good. So with 14:01 to go here in the first quarter, it's the Silverback 7 and the Blue Racers nothing. What a play. A 70 or a 55-yard run by Fred Cromarty. And this place just came unglued. Silver Bay's out there in the end zone doing their thing. We were out with them last night as we had a tour of some of the nightclubs here in the Dayton area. Had a great time, and hopefully you had a chance to be a part of that cut and loose tour is what it was. So it was a great night, and we'll talk about that a little bit later on as the game progresses. But right now, an explosive opening kickoff. Fred Cromarty, a 55-yard run. He took it about 5 yards deep in the end zone. He came out to the right side and just went right up those sidelines. And it was nothing but green grass or green turf all the way into the end zone for him. So Jeff Hubbard will kick off for the Silverbacks. Back deep will be Mike Tatum for the Blue Racers. And a short kick drops it to 25, and it's picked up by Antonio Wells. He's at the 20, and that's where he's going to be pushed out of bounds at the 20-yard line, about the 19-yard line of Marion. Donovan Evans in on the stop on that, so it'll be first and 10 for the Marion Blue Racers at the, where they're going to mark that, the 21-yard line. So the men up front for the Blue Racers, number 95, Michael Hills, number 70, Josh Baker, and number 75, Robert Price. We'll get the skill players here in just a minute. Josh Harris underneath center. One man goes in motion. Harris back to pass, has Tatum open. He's down to the 19-yard line of the Silverbacks. And there was a fumble on the play, but they are going to whistle the ball dead. And it's going to be first and 10 for the Blue Racers at the 18-yard line of the Silverbacks. 12:43 to go here, first quarter, 7-0 Silverbacks. They want to try to avenge a 34-13 loss to the same Marion Blue Racers a couple of weeks ago. Williams out wide to the right. Tatum goes into motion to the far side. Now doubles back. Harris keeps it east to the 15, down to the 11-yard line. And he's going to be stopped there by number 15, Michael Davis. Davis playing in his second game for the Silverbacks. Played last week against Cincinnati. So it'll be second down and about 3 for the Blue Racers at the Silverback 11-yard line. This happened last time. The Silverbacks scored the first touchdown, and then after that, it was all Blue Racers. So Tatum and Williams out wide to the right. Tatum will go into motion. Harris back to pass, has Williams over on the far side. Williams down to the 4-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds by Sean Stewart. And it'll be first down for the Blue Racers at the Silverback 4. First and goal with 11:23 to go here in the first quarter. Tatum and Williams out wide to the right. Robinson out wide to the left. Tatum goes in motion. Hand off to Hayward up the middle, and he's going to be stopped at the 3. No gain, or maybe a pickup of 1. And a whole host of Silverbacks. Nehemiah Simons, James Spikes, and who's the other one here? Sean Stewart. They're all in on the stop on that. Small crowd here tonight, and they're still filing in though. Two wide receivers out to the right, one to the left. Hayward in the backfield. Robinson into motion. Harris keeps it, and he's down at the 1-yard line. And he was stopped by Nehemiah Simons along with James Spikes. So it'll be third down and goal at the 1-yard line. Two wide receivers to the near side. Tatum and Robinson to the near side. Tatum goes in motion. And Harris keeps it, but he's going to be stopped at the 1-yard line. Nice goal line stand by the Silverbacks. And it is now fourth down and 1 at the 1. The fourth and goal at the 1. This would be a great stop for the Silverbacks if they could stop him right here. Two wide receivers out to the right. Williams and Tatum. Hand off to Haywood, and he stopped at the 2-yard line. Great stop by Sean Stewart. And the Silverbacks take over first and 10 at their own 1-yard line. Great stop by the Silverbacks. with 9:05 and counting to go here in the first quarter, the Silverbacks have a chance to capitalize big time on this. They played the Cincinnati Commandos real tough last week, and it's carrying over into this week against the Marion Blue Racers. Blue Racers dressed in white with blue pants and red and blue numerals. Silverbacks in green, or in black with green trim. And here we go, I formation. Stanford under center. Stanford hands off, and we're going to have a safety. Hand off to Russell, Ronald Russell, and he was stopped in the end zone by Michael Cross, and a safety against the Dayton, against the Dayton Silverbacks. So it's now 7-2 with 8:09 to go. We're going to take a timeout, and on the radio side of things, we're going to take a timeout. You're listening to Dayton Silverbacks football here on WolfCountry101.com. Silverbacks lead at 7-2, a safety, a nice defensive stand by the Silverbacks went for naught as they were stopped in the end zone for a safety. Ronald Russell had the ball for the Silverbacks and was tackled in the end zone. So Jeff Hubbard will kick off for the Silverbacks from the goal line. And we are ready. Hubbard will be kicking off from the goal line. Back deep will be Mike Tatum for Marion. 7-2 our score, Dayton. On an opening kickoff return by Fred Cromartie. Squib kick comes down to Tatum at the 6. He to the 10 to the 15. To the right side, Hubbard, and he is going to be stopped at about the 7-yard line. And he's going to be stopped there by Nehemiah Simon and also Daniel Stover. A little pushing going on. I think there's a little chirping going on there. And it's still going on. Nehemiah Simon, better watch. He might get a taunting call against him. So it'll be first and goal for the Blue Racers at the Silverback 6-yard line. Two wide receivers out wide to the right. Tatum and Williams out wide to the right. Robinson out wide to the left with Haywood in the backfield. Hand off to Haywood, and he's going to be stopped at the 6-yard line by James Spike. And he was stopped at the 6-yard line, so no gain. No gain, so it'll be second down and goal for the Blue Racers. Two wide receivers are going out wide to the right once again. Haywood in the backfield. Harris in the shotgun. Robinson coming into motion on the near side. Harris back to pass. As Tatum, and he's going to be stopped at about the 2-yard line, so it'll be third for the Blue Racers. It looks like they're going to mark it at the 2-yard line. A whole slew of Silverbacks in on the stop there. So 6:11 to go here in the first quarter, 7-2 our score. The Dayton Silverbacks lead. Third down and goal at the 2. I formation behind there. Haywood gets the ball and into the end zone he goes for a touchdown. And it's quickly an 8-7 game in favor of Marion. And like I said, this is what happened last time in Marion. Dayton got the first touchdown. They were up 7-0, and very quick, before you knew it, it was 34-7. So Lorenz will come in to kick the extra point for the Marion Blue Racers. Trying to make it 9-7. Good snap, kick is up, and it is good. So with 5:15 to go here in the first quarter, it's the Marion Blue Racers 9 and your Dayton Silverbacks 7. And we'll be right back on the radio side of things. Right after this timeout, you're listening to Dayton Silverbacks football on WolfCountry101.com. Back here at Hara Arena on the radio side of things. Fred Cromarty back deep for the Silverbacks at the one. Here comes the kick end over end, and it goes over Cromarty's head. He's about 7 yards deep. He's to the 5. He's to the 10. He can break it again. And he is going to be stopped at the 19-yard line of the Silverbacks, or of the Blue Racers, by number 7, Brandon Williams. And it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Silverbacks at the Marion 19-yard line. Cromarty breaking it loose here. They're in the first quarter with 2 nice kickoff returns, one for a touchdown, and the other one down to the 19-yard line.
It's all there. Think of that connection.
And here we go. Stover, Bryant, and Cromarty all out wide to the right. Russell in the backfield. And Stanford in the shotgun. Bryant goes in motion. Good snap. Pitch back to Cromarty. Cromarty gets a couple of yards. He's going to be pushed out of bounds by number 99, Michael Cross. And like I said, there's a little chirping going on between these two teams. They didn't really get into it in Marion, but they were face-to-face just like that almost the entire game. So this might be an interesting type of game the rest of the way. So 2nd and 9 from the 18-yard line for the Silverbacks. Stover and Bryant wide to the right for Marty. And we have a timeout. And equipment timeout, I think, by the officials. Mike Cross is carrying his helmet off the field. Looks like he's got a helmet problem. So Cromarty out wide to the left, Russell in the backfield with Bryant and Stover out wide to the right. Bryant goes in motion. Stanford back to pass, and we are going to have a pass interference against. We're going to have a pass interference against the Marion Blue Racers. Pass interference, it looks like it's been thrown at the 8-yard line, so it's going to be an automatic first down for the Silverbacks. Illegal use of the hands by the defense. And it'll be a illegal contact is what it was. It'll be an automatic first down for the Silverbacks at the Marion 13-yard line. 2 wide receivers out to the left. Bryant will go into motion. Bryant does go in motion. Stanford back to pass. Has time. He's going to fake it, and now throw it. He's got a man on the near side, and that's Cromarty, down about the, where are they going to mark it? About the 7 yard line. So it'll be second down and about 5 at the 7 yard line for these Dayton Silverbacks. They trail by 2, 9-7, and that was courtesy of a safety on their first series of plays. Bryant goes out wide to the left, two wide receivers to the near side, Cromarty and Stover. Stanford under center, hands off to Marshall at the middle. He's to the 5, he's down to the 1, and he's just short of the goal line, so it's a first down for the Silverbacks. First and goal, and they are knocking on the door once again. 2:12 to go here in quarter number 1. I formation by the Silverbacks with Victor Tolbert. Tolbert gets it. He stopped at the 2, and he's going to be drugged down by number 24, Brian Williams. So it'll be second down, a loss of about 2 on that. So it'll be second down, make that a loss of 1. It'll be second down and goal at the 2-yard line of Marion. Cromarty going out wide to the left. I formation, Tolbert and Russell in the I formation. Tolbert the I back. Alley-oop pass to Stover, just a little bit high. Goes out of bounds, and it's going to be third down and goal from the 2-yard line. 1:11 to go here in the first quarter. Silverbacks trail it 9-7. Things got off to a great start by the Silverbacks. A 55-yard run or kickoff return. Here we go. I formation. Tolbert in the I. Man comes into motion on the near side. Hand off to Tolbert. Tolbert gets knocked back to the 4-yard line. And he's going to be stopped on the play by big number 99, Mike Cross. So it'll be now fourth down. It'll be fourth down at the 5-yard line with 22 seconds left. And Hubbard will kick a field goal, and they will mark it at the 13-yard line. So a 23-yard field goal by Jeff Hubbard. High snap, kick is up, and it is no good, wide to the left. So it'll be first and 10 for the Marion Blue Racers at the 5-yard line, their own 5-yard line. A great opportunity by the Silverbacks wasted. So it's going to be 7.4 seconds left here in the first quarter. We get one play off, and that'll be the end of the quarter then. Tatum out wide to the left, two wide receivers out wide to the right, or wide to the left. Man goes in motion. Harris has Tatum on the far side, gets to the 11-yard line, or make it to the 14-yard line, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Stop was made by Vittorio Jones. That's the end of the first quarter with the score. The Marion Blue Racers 9 and the Lord Dayton Silverbacks 7. We'll be right back after this timeout. You're listening to Silverbacks football on Wolf Country 101. And you're watching it on VATV.
Thank you.
TD route by Russell Hardy, and then the Silverbacks have given up 9 unanswered points. And it'll be first and, it'll be second down and 3. We'll make it second down and 2 from the 13-yard line of Marion. Two wide receivers out to the left. Tatum out wide to the right. Haywood in the backfield. And make that, take that back. A shuttle pass right to Williams, and he has it at the, he has a first down at the 22-yard line of Marion. So another first down for Marion, and they move the chains. The Silverbacks need a big, big stop right here. Williams and Tatum going out wide to the left with Robinson to the near side. Wells is in the backfield. Tatum, handoff to Wells, or handoff to Haywood, and he is stopped in the backfield, a loss of 4. Make that a loss of 2. He was stopped at the 20-yard line, so it'll be second down and 12 at the 20-yard line of Marion with 13:57 to go here in the first half. Josh Harris, former quarterback at Bowling Green. Williams and Tatum out wide to the left. Robinson wide to the right with Haywood in the backfield. Tatum comes into motion to the near side. Pass to Robinson right at the 20, and he's going to be stopped by Vittorio Jones. So he was stopped at the 20-yard line. Make it the 19-yard line. So it'll be third down and 11 for the Blue Racers at their own 21. Williams goes out wide to the rest. Wide to the left, Robinson and Tatum to the right. Wells in motion. Harris back to pass. He's going to be flushed out. And he's going to be dropped. Nice job by James Spikes. And a loss of 4. And it's back to the 18-yard line. James Spikes got the sack. And it's fourth down. Fourth down and looks like 14 for these Blue Racers. And that'll bring on Tyler Lorenz. He's going to try a 50-yard field goal here. And spotted at the 10. Robinson to hold. And that goal is only 10 feet wide. So that's going to be short. Cromartie will pick it up at the goal line. He's to the 10, he's to the 15. He's going to be dropped at the 20-yard line. And that'll be first and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 20-yard line. So a nice stop by James Spikes. It turns into a field goal attempt. But you just never know anymore with Spikes, or with Cromartie. And he electrified this crowd right off the bat with a 55-yard touchdown. So here we go, the Silverbacks break the huddle with Cromartie, Bryant, and Sover all wide to the left. Looks like Marcus Fields is in the backfield this time around. Bryant into motion. Stanford looking downfield, fires downfield for Stover, and it hits the top of the glass, and it's out of bounds. So it'll be second down and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 20-yard line. So that was a good combination last week, Stanford to Stover. That got things started for the Silverbacks last week with Cincinnati. Cromartie got wide to the right with Bryant and Stover wide to the left. And Fails in the backfield. And we have a penalty markers all over the place. And we have Michael Hills and Chris Stanford drawing at each other a little bit. So what do we got here? It looks like it's going to be against the Silverbacks, illegal procedure against the Silverbacks, so it'll knock it back 5 yards. It'll be second down and 15 from the Silverback 15. Three wide receivers out to the near side with Bryant going in motion here. Fails in the backfield. Bryant in motion. Stanford back to pass. Has a man. Tries to get it to Stover once again. And it's incomplete, so the third down. So third down and 15 from the 15 of Dayton. Dayton trails 9-7 with 9:50 to go here in the first half. So here we go. Two wide receivers out to the right this time. We'll make that all three receivers out to the right hand side. With Fails on the left side of Stanford. Cromarty in motion. Comes to the line. Stanford back to pass. He's going to be flushed out. Now tries to get it over to, looks like Bryant. Goes over his head. People wanted a flag on that. But it went over his head and it's incomplete. So that's going to bring out Jeff Hubbard. And he's going to try and kick a long field goal.
Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you purchase a 50-50 raffle ticket. Your Silver Bay.
See where they're going to spot the ball. Hubbard, and before the game today, he was kicking them pretty good. They will place the ball at the 8-yard line of Dayton. So it'll be a 53-yard field goal by Hubbard. Kick is up, and it just barely missed it. I mean, it couldn't have been no more than a foot underneath the goalpost. As a matter of fact, I think it hit the bottom of the goalpost. So it's, we're going to have a media timeout. We're going to keep it right here, though. So Wolf Country 101 is proud to present Dayton Silverbacks football. And our next game here on WolfCountry101.com will be in 2 weeks when the Silverbacks travel to Chicago to take on the Chicago Knights for the first time. The Knights 1-1 going into tonight's action. And they are... I think they are playing Port Huron tonight. Or no, Port Huron's down in Cincinnati tonight. And Indianapolis is in Chicago. So we're having a contest go on. Name that to for a ticket to the Country Concert Jamboree in Ringo on June the 4th. That's sponsored by WolfCountry101.com. It's for a great cause. It's for the Stop the Bullying campaign. And every school's got bullies. It's got to stop. There's no room for it. Bullies end up in jail. And it's obvious because it happened in North Carolina. One of the kids that was bullied stepped up to the plate, told the police or told the principal or one of the school officials, called the police and had the kids arrested. That's the way to do it. And on Saturday, June the 4th, starting at 9 a.m. at the Dark County Fairgrounds, 10 bands will be playing until 11 p.m. at the Dark County Fairgrounds. So get your tickets. Log on to WolfCountry101.com for more information. Here we go. Williams and Wells out wide to the right with Tatum up to the right or to the left side. Wells comes in motion to the far side. Harris back to pass, looking for Wells, and that's going to be an interference call. It's going to be an interference call against Mike Davis of the Silverbacks at the, looks like they're going to mark it at the 18-yard line of Miami, or of Marion. So it'll be an automatic first down for the Marion Blue Racers. Illegal contact by the Silverbacks, and it'll be an automatic first down at the 10-yard line. It'll be a first and 10 at the 10 for Marion with 7:56 to go here in the first half. Clock winding down. Tatum out wide to the left, with Wells and Williams wide to the right. Haywood in the backfield. Tatum comes into the motion on the near side. Hand off to Haywood, and he's going to be stopped at the 10-yard line. Looks like Simons is there, and Johnny Wright is there. James Fikes and Marcus Fales was in on the stop on that one, too. So a whole host of... half the team for the Silverbacks were on the stop on that one. So second and 10 for the Blue Racers at the 10. Tatum comes into motion on the near side. Harris back to pass, has Tatum at the 11, and he's going to be dropped right there. Looks like Mike Davis was one of them, along with Donovan Evans and Chris Respers, all in on the stop. A pickup of one, so it'll be third down and 9 at the 11-yard line of Marion with 6:38 to go. 9-7 our score, and here of late, it's been low-scoring games for the Silverbacks. And they scored 13 points against Marion and 15 against Cincinnati. Wells in motion, Harris back to pass, he's going to run with it. He's to the 15, he's going to be dropped at the 19-yard line. Just short of the first down by a yard, and it's going to be fourth down at the 19. Fourth down and one at the 19. Glad you can join us here on DHEV tonight, along with WolfCountry101.com. Doug Brown with you. 5:57 to go here in the first half, and 9-7 is our score in favor of Marion. Two wide receivers to the near side. Hand off to Haywood, he's got the first down to the 22-yard line, so big number 99, Mike Cross was also in there at fullback, leading the way. Clock running, 5.5 to go here in the first half. One of the dasher pads have come down on about the 5-yard line, just to our left. Tatum out wide to the left with Wells and Williams wide to the right with Haywood in the backfield. Tatum comes into motion on the near side. Harris back to pass, has Tatum, and it was thrown at his feet, so it'll be second down and 10 at the 21-yard line. I'd like to remind everybody, coming up on April the 29th, Congo is going to sponsor a cut and loose road trip to Cincinnati to see the Silverbacks take on the Cincinnati Commandos. It's a Friday night. Information, log on to DaytonSilverbacks.com or SilverbacksFootball.com. Harris back to pass, has Tatum wide open in the end zone, and it's blocked! What a nice play by Chris Respers. Michael Davis on the stop. What a nice save. That's a touchdown saving. That was a touchdown saving stop there for Michael Davis. Third down and 10 for the Silverbacks at the Marion, or for the Blue Racers, I'm sorry. Blue Racers at the 21-yard line. Two wide receivers out to the left. Haywood in in the backfield with Caden in motion. Harris in the shotgun. Back to pass, hands off to Haywood. Haywood's up to the 26-yard line. He's going to be stopped right there, I mean the 24-yard line. And it's going to be fourth down. It's going to be fourth down and about five for the silver, or for the Blue Racers at the 23-yard line of Dayton. Wells and Williams coming out wide to the right with Tatum out wide to the left. Tatum coming into motion, goes towards the line. Harris back to pass. And the pass is incomplete, and Dayton will take over first down at the 23-yard line. That is a great stop by the Silverbacks with the clock running at 2:50 to go here in the first half. Don't forget, after every game here at Hara Arena, the Dayton Silverbacks, along with the Silver Babes, will be going to Boston's Bistro, located at 7500 North Main Street at the corner of Dog's Leg Road and Main Street, along with and Westbrook Road. Three roads right there. And you can meet the guys and the girls of the Silverbacks. So first and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 23-yard line. Two wide receivers out to the right side with Cromartie coming into motion on the near side. Russell in the backfield. Stanford back to pass. Has his arm hit, and it's going to fall incomplete about the 7-yard line, or about the 11-yard line. And it's going to be second down and goal. Second down and 10, I should say, at the 23-yard line. 1:39 to go here in the first half. A quick moving first half here at Hara Arena tonight. 9-7 our score. Marion leads it. Coming up on the 1 minute warning. Stover and Bryant goes wide to the right. Cromartie will go into motion also on the right side. There's Cromartie, and it goes into motion. Stanford back to pass, and a screen pass to Russell. Russell, he put up, or make that, Tolbert. He gets down to the 5-yard line, making the 4-yard line. That's first and goal for the Silverbacks with 1 minute to go. That's a 1 minute warning, so that means that we're going to take a break. And when we come back, it'll be first and goal for the Silverbacks. You're listening to Silverbacks Football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV. Back here at Hara Arena with 1 minute to go here in the first half. The Silverbacks knocking on the door, first and goal at the 3-yard line of Marion. Silverbacks coming up to the line of scrimmage. Coach Shepard running off the field. Two wide receivers out to the right-hand side. Bryant and Stover to the wide, or handoff to Russell up the middle, and he stopped at the 4-yard line. A loss of one. It'll be second down and goal at the 4-yard line. And we have a timeout on the field. An official's timeout. And don't know why. We have a timeout called by Marion with 46.3 seconds to go here in the first half. 9-7 our score. Glad you can join us tonight on DATV. Broadcasting to it from Hara Arena. Glad to have them aboard tonight. And you're also listening to us on WolfCountry101.com. Great listeners, great viewers tonight here on the internet and on TV. On Friday, April the 29th, I was telling you before, the Silverback, a chance to show your support and have fun at the same time. The Dayton Silverbacks, in partnership with Cutting Loose Party Bus and Bud Light, are giving you the chance to take a party bus down to Cincinnati for our rematch with the Commandos. First and goal for the, or second and goal. Bad snap, and it's picked up by Marion. And it looks like, and we're gonna have a, we got penalty markers all over the place. And it looks like Eric Starks and Marcus Allen were going at it pretty good. And it looks like some fists were thrown. Penalty markers are all over the place. 39.5 seconds to go here in the first half. And the officials are talking at about the 10-yard line. So here we go. Personal foul on both teams. It'll be first down for the Marion Blue Racers at their own 9-yard line with 39 and a half seconds to go here in the first half. A 55-yard touchdown run or kickoff return to open the game for the Silverbacks by Fred Cromartie is the only score that they've got so far. And a touchdown and a safety for Marion. So here we go, Tatum out wide to the left, Williams and Robinson wide to the right. Wells in the backfield. Harris calling the play, back to pass, and the pass is incomplete. And we have a penalty marker down on the play, offside against the Silverbacks. So it's going to be first down and 5. Let's see where they mark it. See where they mark it here. It'll be first and 5 wherever they mark it. 35.2 seconds to go. It'll be first and 5 at the 14-yard line. The Blue Racers will get the ball to start the second half when we get there. So here we go with Robinson and Williams coming out wide to the right with Tatum out wide to the left. Wells in the backfield. Williams going in motion. Harris back to pass. And he's going to have, there's a penalty marker down. The pass is incomplete. Penalty marker down. It's thrown in the area of holding, and that's exactly what it's going to be against the Marion Blue Racers. So it'll be first and looks like, see how they mark this. Is holding on number 75, Robert Price. We got a final score in Cincinnati beat Port Huron 47-23 this afternoon. Somebody's got to stop Cincinnati. No doubt about that. And next up for, well, we got Cincinnati in about 3 weeks down in Cincinnati, so we got to get our act together and be able to beat those guys down there. 30.1 seconds to go here in the first half. 9-7 to score. Fast moving first half. 9-7 our score. Coach Lorenzo Stiles of Dayton getting his defensive troops all together. We have Vittorio Jones, Nehemiah Simons, Josh Davis, Johnny Wright, James Spikes out there, along with Chris Rester and Michael Davis. That's your defensive lineup for, and Donovan Evans is also out there. So here we go. Tatum in motion. Two men were in motion, and they didn't call it. Here's the Harris. Harris at 2-10 to the 15, and he's going to be dropped there, and we're going to have a timeout called. And it's going to be second down and 4 from the 16. And we have a timeout on the field called by Marion. So, and we have a Antonio Wells is slow to get up for Marion. Coach Ryan Terry coming out for the Marion Blue Racers, the head coach, and checking on his wide receiver and running back. 22.3 seconds to go here in the first half. Wells getting up on his own, walking out from his own power, so that's a good sign for Marion. A little bit of smaller crowd than what we had with Cincinnati, but it's still a good game. 9-7 with 22.3 seconds to go here in the first half. Low-scoring affair. Usually indoor games are pretty high-scoring. But not tonight. It's a battle of defense. So here we go. Tatum out wide to the left with Williams, and Robinson wide to the right, and Haywood in the backfield. Harris calling out the signals. Robinson comes into motion on the near side. Harris back to pass. Looking downfield. He's got Williams at the 22, and he's up to the 25. And that's going to be good enough for a first down with 20. The clock didn't even run. The clock didn't even run on that. There's still 22.3 seconds to go. And the officials finally realized it. And one of the officials on the sidelines, the alternate official, saw that. So they're going to run off some time, I guess. Should run off about 4 seconds or so. We're going to run off down to 18 seconds. So that's where we'll get a first down and 10 for the Blue Racers. Just on the other side of the 25-yard line into Dayton territory. Robinson and Williams out wide to the right. Tatum on the left side. Haywood in the backfield. Harris back to pass. Has time. And has a completion. And it's to Robinson on the near side. And he's good enough for a first down with 11 seconds to go.
11 seconds.
Quickly up to the line as the Blue Racers, as they try to capitalize on this. Harris in the shotgun, back to pass, has time. Has Williams, touchdown. A 15-yard touchdown pass from Harris to Williams. And it's now 15-7 with 3.7 seconds to go. Here in the first half. The official coming over to the near side to the clock operator. And the extra point will be tried by Tyler Lorenz. Timothy Robinson to hold. Trying to make this a 9-point game. So here's the snap. Good snap. Pick is up. And is it good? No good. Wide to the left. So with 5 seconds left. Now we moved it back to 5 seconds.
5 seconds remaining.
So with 5 seconds remaining here in the first half, it's Marion 15 and your Dayton Silverbacks 7. I'd like to remind everybody that the Dayton Silverbacks are hosting a clinic, and it's for the younger group. And it says, does your child have any interest in the exciting world of cheerleading? If so, your Dayton Silverbacks would love to help. They will be hosting a cheer clinic for children 10 and under at our May 7th home game. Your child will get the experience to experience the day in the life of a Silver Babes. And believe me, those girls, they really work at what they do. They are very, very good. They're probably one of the best in the league, if not the best. We'll give you more information on that. If you want to get on silverbacksfootball.com and find out more information, you can call 425. We'll get back to it here in just a second. We're getting ready for the kickoff. We're already back deep for the Silverbacks with 5 seconds to go. Lorenz, squib kick coming down at the 15. Picked up by an up back, and he's going to be stopped back. He stopped at the 20. Victor Tolbert picks it up for the Silverbacks. And it's going to be first and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 20-yard line. For more information on the Silver Babes, you can call the Silver Babes Clinic. You can call 425-8050 to sign your child up for this one-day event. The price is $25 per child to participate. Here we go, two wide receivers out to the near side. Cromartie out to the right. Stanford. In the shotgun. Back to pass. There's the clock. Down to Cromartie, and it's knocked down by Haywood. And that's the end of the first half. What's the score? The Marion Blue Racers 15 and your Dayton Silverbacks 7. We'll be right back after this timeout. You're listening to Silverback Football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV in Dayton. We're back at Hara Arena. This is Doug Brown coming to you live from Hara Arena. And I'd like to thank DATV for coming out tonight. And we are on DATV also tonight. Glad you can join us here on the internet, Wolf Country 101 and DATV. Getting ready for second half action, the Marion Blue Racers from Marion, Ohio. They lead the Dayton Silverbacks 15-7. And what was a quick first half kind of slowed down. So the Silverbacks will kick off. They will go left to right on your screen on TV and on the your computer. The left to right, dressed in black with green trim, green numbers, black helmets. The Blue Racers in their road white jerseys with blue pants and white helmets, red and white, or blue and red numerals. Top half is blue, the bottom half is red. Kind of a unique scheme for the Blue Racers. Back deep is Mike Tatum. And second half is underway. Kick coming down, and Tatum has it about the 3. He's to the 10. He's going to be dropped at the 11-yard line by Russell and Sean Stewart. And it'll be first and 10 for the Blue Racers at their own 13-yard line, as we are just underway here in quarter number 3 from Hara Arena. Small Crandall in hand, but they got a. The ones that were late getting here, they missed a 55-yard touchdown run by Fred Cromartie to start the game. Two wide receivers out to the left-hand side, or to the right, one to the left. Wells comes into motion. Harris back to pass, looking, has time. Looking for Williams, and he's got a touchdown. A 37-yard touchdown pass from Harris to Williams, and it's quickly 21-7. That's how fast the game can go. That's how fast they can score here in indoor football. Tyler Lorenz to kick the extra point for Marion. with Robinson to hold. Snap is good, kick is up, and it is good. So with 13:20 to go here in the third quarter, it's the Blue Racers 22 and your Dayton Silverbacks 7. That's not the way they wanted to start this second half. The Silverbacks, that is. Now they're going to have to come back and they're going to have to get a quick 7. So 13:20 to go, third quarter, and a quick score by the Blue Racers. So back deep will be Fred Cromarty with Sean Stewart and Victor Tolbert and Ronald Russell up. The up backs for Dayton. So here's the kickoff. A pooch kick, and that was almost interference. The official's ready to throw the flag, and he has not. Oh, yeah, he did. That was interference. You have a penalty marker down on the play. The officials are discussing it. It looked like the guy from the Blue Racers went right into the Silverback, and he didn't give him enough room. Didn't allow him any room to catch the ball. So they're still huddling at about the 15-yard line. 13:13 to go here in the first half or third quarter. The officials are still huddling, and they're going to call interference on Dayton.
Let's go!
They're going to call interference on the Dayton. Oh, no, they're going to call it on Marion. I'm sorry. I was going to say. So it'll be first and 10 for the Silverbacks, and they're going to have to see where they're going to mark the ball. Ryan Terry is out waiting for an explanation. The Silverbacks are ready to go. So the Silverbacks will have the ball first down and 10. The ball is resting at the 21. And the official is talking to Ryan Terry, and Ryan Terry is very animated over there on the far side. So the Silverbacks will get the ball first and 10 at the Marion 14-yard line. Interference on the kicking team, so that'll give the Silverbacks the ball. We have Stover and Bryant wide to the right with Cromarty wide to the left and Russell in the slot. Stanford back to pass. Looking. He's going to take off. He's down to the 10, down to the 6-yard line where he's run out of bounds by a group of Racers, Blue Racers, led by number 3, Mike Ellison. So it'll be second down at the 7-yard line. Make it second down and about 4. Bryant and Stover out wide to the right. Cromarty wide to the left. Russell in the eye. Hand off to Russell. He's up down to the.
Touchdown.
Is he into the end zone? No, he's down to the 1. Down to the 1-yard line is Russell. And it's first and goal for the Silverbacks at the 1. Stanford under center.
Keep it, Chris. Touchdown.
And he keeps that. Stanford keeps it. Touchdown, Silverbacks. Stanford, a one-yard run. Quarterback keeper, and it's 22-13. So Hubbard will be in to attempt the extra point with Stover to hold. They're going to try and make this an 8-point game within a one-possession game. Good snap. Kick is up, and it is good right down the middle. So with 10:59 to go here in the third quarter, it's the Marion Blue Racers 22 and your Dayton Silverbacks 14. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back. You're listening to Dayton Silverbacks football on WolfCountry101.com. And watching it on DATV. Here at Hara Arena, the Dayton Silverbacks on the board for the second time tonight. A Chris Stanford 1-yard quarterback sneak, and he brings the Silverbacks within 8, 22-14. And they are I think they're the best in the league, to be honest with you. So Hubbard to kick off. Tatum back deep, standing at his goal line. End over end kick coming down to Hubbard about 8 yards deep in the end zone. He's to the 5. He's up to the 10. Reverses his field. He's to the 15. To the 20. 25. And dropped at the Dayton 23-yard line by... Wallace Morris. And we have a timeout on the field with an injured Dayton Silverback. I'd like to remind everybody that in 2 weeks from tonight, the Dayton Silverbacks will be in Chicago to take on the Chicago Knights. You can hear all the action right here on WolfCountry101.com. And the kickoff is set for 5 o'clock in the afternoon on Saturday. So that's an early start time in Chicago. 10:43 to go here in the third quarter. The Silverbacks trail by 8, 22-14. Congo, right in front of us.
Let's go, P!
Silverbacks out there on the field with Josh Davis, Johnny Wright, James Spikes, the front line. Trying to stop this Marion attack. Williams goes in motion to the far side for Marion. Now cuts upfield. Harris loses it. Ball's on the field. Haywood picks it up and has dropped it to 21 by Vittorio Jones. And he hit Haywood hard.
Stop,
Vittorio Jones. Pickup of about 3. It'll be fourth down. Another change in the marker to second down and 8 at the 20-yard line of Dayton. Two wide receivers to the near side. Harris back to pass, has time. Tried to get it to Robinson, and it was batted around. Looks like Michael Davis had a chance to get it, along with looks like Donovan Evans to make that Nehemiah Simons. Had a chance, they were bobbling it, and it was bouncing around like a volleyball, and it finally dropped, so it'll be third down. Third down for the Blue Racers. Williams comes in motion, Tatum in motion on the near side. Harris back to pass, he's gonna step up in the pocket, and had Wells wide open, and it went right through his hand, so it'll be fourth down for the Blue Racers at the 21-yard line. A big stop. Big stop by the defense so far, and that's going to bring out Tyler Lorenz. Try and make this an 11-point lead. Josh Davis hurrying up off the field for the Silverbacks. And they will put the ball down at the Marion 21-yard line. Kick is up, and it's good. So a 32-yard field goal by Marion.
And don't forget to get your 50-50.
And that makes it a 25-14 game. We have a timeout on the field. We're going to take a timeout, too. You're listening to Silverback Football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV in Dayton. Cromartie back deep for the Silverbacks. Lorenz to kick for the Blue Racers. 8:19 to go here in the third quarter. We were at 15-7 at halftime so far. So far it's been 10-7 here in the third quarter, and we've only played less than 7 minutes of this third quarter. Kick underway and coming down to Cromartie. The ball goes out of bounds, hit the glass. Goes out of bounds, so it's going to be first and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 5-yard line. And that's not where they really wanted to start. They were hoping that Cromartie would get a good kickoff return. And he's had a couple of good ones tonight. Clock running, 7:57 to go here in the third quarter. I'd like to remind everybody that when you come to a Silverbacks game, that after the game you can get on the field and meet and greet the Silverback football players along with the Silver Bays. They will be signing autographs after each and every game right here at Hara Arena. You can go right down on the field and meet your favorite Silverback and Silver Bay. So here we go. Stanford under center. Trent Marlowe, the center, hand off to Victor Tolbert, and he gets up to the 19-yard line of the Silverbacks, and it's going to be a first down. First down for the Silverbacks at their own 19-yard line. An explosive run by Tolbert, a good run by Tolbert. So here we go. We have Victor Jett into the game. And he's on the right side along with Bryant. This time Stanford is going to keep it, and he's going to get maybe a yard up to the 20-yard line. And he's stopped there on the play by Bryson Lawrence, or make that Ryan Palmer of Marion. So it'll be second down and about 9.5. He picked up about a half a yard on that one. 6:16 to go here in quarter number three. The Silverbacks trail by 11, 25-14. Jet and Bryant wide to the right. Cromartie wide to the left with Tolbert in the backfield. Moves to the left side as Stanford comes in, and we have an offside by Mike Cross of Marion, and that's going to move him up 5 yards to the 25-yard line. So it'll be second and five for the Silverbacks at midfield. Jet and Bryant wide to the right with Cromartie wide to the left. Stanford in the shotgun. And now we have movement on the Silverbacks, the left side. Eric Starks moved for the Silverbacks. And it's going to knock them back. They just lost the 5 yards that they picked up on that, on the Marion penalty. So we start back over where we were. Second and nine at the 20. 5.5 to go, third quarter. Stanford in the shotgun. Takes the snap. He's going to run with it. He's running to the right side. He's to the 20. To the 25. Dives to the 20 of Marion, and he's got a first down for the Silverbacks. Nice run by Stanford, and that's what the Silverbacks really need right at this point. Good running offense, and along with the defense. 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter, 25-14 Marion. Cromartie goes out wide to the left with Jett and Bryant wide to the right, and Tolbert in the backfield, right beside Stanford. Stanford in the shotgun. Good step by Marlowe, and it looks like Eric Starks moved again. So they're going to knock it back 5 yards, and it's going to be a penalty on Dayton. So it's going to be first and 15 at the 25-yard line. .436 to go, third quarter. Cromartie out wide to the left with Bryant and Victor Jett wide to the right. Stanford back to pass. That being rushed. Almost had Cromartie, but it was broken up by Andre Troy of Marion. So it'll be third down. Make that second down and 15 at the 25-yard line at midfield. Up next for the Silverbacks, a trip to Chicago in 2 weeks. They're off next week, and a well-deserved break. Cromartie out wide to the left with Bryant and Jett wide to the right. Tolbert in the backfield with Stanford in the shotgun. Stanford back to pass, has time. Has Cromartie wide open, almost intercepted though. It looked like Brian Williams had a chance to intercept. He came out of nowhere because Cromartie was wide open right in front of the Dayton bench, and Williams knocked it away. So it'll be third down and 15 at the 25 at midfield. 3:12 to go here in the third quarter. Time winding down in this one. We've got Marlowe at center, the Starks and West, the other two up front. Cromartie in motion, Stanford back to pass, has time. He's going to step up in the pocket, and he's going to be dropped for a loss of 4. at the 24, and Stanford is in pain. And we're going to have a timeout, injury timeout, and Stanford is not getting up. He is not getting up, and it looks like he's grabbing his shin. It could have been the way he was tackled there. So Coach Shepard coming out to check on his quarterback. And the backup quarterback is Daniel Stover. And Stover came in the first half of the game at Marion a couple of weeks ago. He came in for the injured Bruce Jones, who dislocated his shoulder. When he will be back, nobody knows, if at all, to be honest with you, because of the dislocated shoulder. Takes a while to get healed. So here comes Stover out of the bench. And we'll see who's going to be the, we'll see if he's going to be the quarterback. So Stanford up on his feet. We'll see if he's going to walk off under his own power. And he's running off, he's trotting off the field. Looks like he's going to be okay. So we're going to have Jeff Hubbard, looks like, coming out. Jeff Hubbard coming out to attempt a field goal. We're going to see how far that is. About a 47-yard field goal. He's going to put it down at the 13-yard line. Mike Tatum back deep for the Blue Racers. Good snap. Kick is up, and it's long enough, and just wide to the left. Just wide to the left. He couldn't have missed it by no more than about two, three feet. That's just the way things have been going for the Dayton Silverbacks tonight on the field goal, just a little bit to the left. So with 2:18 to go here in the third quarter, it's Marion 25 and Dayton 14. Doug Brown here with you. We'll be here with you in 2 weeks when the Silverbacks travel to Chicago to take on the Chicago Knights. And that is a Saturday afternoon affair. And the game will start at, looks like it's scheduled for 4 o'clock. It could be 4 o'clock their time. I'm not real sure. Check the CIFL website for more information on that one. Here we go. Two wide receivers out to the right and one to the left. Tatum on the left side going in motion. Harris to run with the ball. He's to the 10, up to the 15, to the 16, to the 17. He's going to be dropped there by Sean Stewart. And Nehemiah Simons on the stop for the Silverbacks. It's going to be first down for the Blue Racers at the Marion 17-yard line with a minute 55 to go here in quarter number three. Two wide receivers to the near side. That's Tatum and Robinson. Tatum going in motion on the far side. Now he's come set. Williams also on the far side. Robinson in motion. Harris back to pass. Has Haywood in the flat, but he's going to be stopped on the screen pass. Spikes on the stop, along with fails. And it's going to be second down and 12 for the Blue Racers at their own 15-yard line with 1:07 to go here in the third quarter. Two wide receivers out to the right-hand side with Tatum going in motion to the left, or to the right. Harris back to pass. That ball batted up in the air, and it's picked up by Harris. And he's going to be dropped at the 11-yard line. Make that big number 75, Robert Price, picking it up for the big number 75, Robert Price, got the batted ball for Marion, and he lost about another 3 or 4 yards, so it's going to be third down, and looks like 15 or 16 from the 11-yard line. They got to get to the Dayton 23. And we have a timeout on the field with 5.6 seconds to go. We're going to keep it right here, because we're going to be taking a timeout here in just a couple of seconds. 5.6 seconds left here in quarter number three. That's going to be a good game down in Cincinnati after what happened last week here. Man in motion to the front. Bad snap. Harris picks it up and throws it out of bounds. And it's incomplete. And it's going to be fourth down, and that's the end of quarter number three. With the score, the Marion Blue Racers 25, and your Dayton Silverbacks 14. You're listening to Dayton Silverbacks football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV here in Dayton. Be sure to join us June the 4th at the Dark County Fairgrounds for Country Concert Jamboree, sponsored by WolfCountry101.com. Everything starts at 9 a.m. on Saturday morning, 10 bands, and it's going to last until 11 or 12 o'clock at night. It's a big day. It's also in reference to helping support the Stop Bullying campaign. Tyler Lorenz to kick a field goal. It's going to be a long one. I don't think he's going to make this. And it's blocked! And it's going to be picked up by, it's going to be first and 10 for the Silverbacks at the Marion 7-yard line.
Let's go!
Nice job by the defense on that one. Chance to make it. Try to cut into this 25-14 lead. 14-30 remaining here in the game, and a tight one at it. And a tight one as it is. Stanford is back in at quarterback. Russell in the backfield. Three wide receivers out to the far side. Stanford under center. Hands off to Russell up the middle, and he's got to be blasted right at the 5-yard line by number 27, Lorenzo Best. He smacked him hard right at the 5-yard line. That's going to be second down and goal at the 5. Silverbacks have been involved in a couple of close ones here at Hara Arena. You get a chance to come out and see them. They got 3 home games remaining. I think the next one is against Indianapolis right here at Hara Arena. But I'll check that here in just a second. Three wide receivers out to the right side with Marshall in the backfield. Stanford under center. Marion fans coming alive. Stanford has it. He's going to be dropped first. He's going to be sacked by Best at the 12-yard line. A good contingent of fans from Marion. They're yelling defense, and they got it. Ball back to the 11-yard line, so it'll be third and goal at the 11 with 12:55 to go here in quarter number 4. Coming to you from Hara Arena, we are on DATV and and wolfcountry101.com. Stover, Bryant, and Cromarty all out to the right-hand side. Marshall on the left of Stanford. Stanford back to pass. Last time, thrown in the corner for Cromarty, and it goes over his head. Stover. And it goes out of bounds, and it'll be fourth down and goal at the 11-yard line. So that's going to bring on Jeff Hubbard to kick a field goal from the 11. And that's a chip shot, but there's a big, huge American flag hanging right over his head, too. They will mark it at the 18-yard line, so a 28-yard field goal for Hubbard. 11:45 to go here in the fourth quarter. Snap. And that is blocked. Going to come down, and it's going to be dropped and picked up by Michael Ellison, and it's going to be a touchback, and the Blue Racers will get the ball at the 5-yard line with 11:31 to go here in the fourth quarter. And we got a couple of people down, and we got a penalty marker down thrown, and it looks like it's going against Dayton. We're going to have to see who that's on. It looks like it's going against Hubbard. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be called on Jeff Hubbard. I'm sorry, but that's not smart. You got him pinned back at the 5-yard line, and then you get a dumb call like that. It's a penalty against Jeff Hubbard. A personal foul against Jeff Hubbard, which is a dumb call. And that's going to be a 10-yard penalty. And it's going to make it first and 10 for the Blue Racers at their own 15-yard line. And we have a timeout, official's timeout. And Derek Shepherd is on the field. He wants an explanation of what happened. No telling what goes on underneath. I mean, something could have happened to Hubbard. Marion could have done something to Hubbard and that got him a little upset. And Hubbard gets called for the foul, or the personal foul. So here we go, with Williams and Wells out wide to the right, with Tatum out wide to the left, Haywood in the backfield, and 11:31 to go here in the fourth quarter. Silverbacks had a chance to score, but they blew it. Had a blocked punt. Harris on the keeper. He gets smacked by Vittorio Jones at the 18-yard line of Marion. Jones loses his helmet. Vittorio Jones has an interesting day job. He works for the Dayton Dragons, and the Dayton Dragons are currently playing right now down at Fifth Third Field here in Dayton. So second down and 7 from the 19-yard line. Tatum in motion to the near side. Now he reverses his field, goes to the far side. Harris back to pass, being rushed, and he's going to be dropped and sacked by Sean Stewart. And he's going to lose at least 2, and it's going to be 3rd and 9 from the 17-yard line of Marion with 10:23 to go. The Silverbacks need the ball back, and they got to score twice. Silverback 25-14 our score here in Dayton. Marion leads it by 11. Three wide receivers out to the far side. Haywood in the backfield. Tatum in motion to the near side. Pass downfield, and it's incomplete to Tatum. This goes over his hand, outstretched hand, and Tatum is down. He's slow to get up in the end zone. Vittorio Jones in on the block or the knockaway, the tip on that. So it'll be fourth down and nine at the 17-yard line of Marion. 9:22 to go, and the clock is running. Tatum holding his hand a little bit. Harris getting in a play from the field, or from the bench. Silverback players, Stewart and Spikes trying to get the fans up. Make some noise. We got a timeout by Marion. We're going to step away for a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Silverbacks football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV here in Dayton. Here in Dayton, 9:02 to go. Doug Brown with you. The Silverbacks trail the Marion Blue Racers 25-14. The Blue Racers have a fourth and nine at the Marion 17-yard line. The Blue Racers trying to go to 4-1 on the season. Dayton trying to go 2-3. Dayton can ill afford to lose this one. That would make them 1-2 at home with three games remaining here at Hara Arena. And it's the last three games of the season. So it looks like Donovan Evans is back deep for Dayton. And Tyler Lorenz will try about a 51-yard field goal from the 9-yard line. Good snap, kick is up, and it's blocked again. It's going to be picked up by the Silverbacks. Michael Davis. And we have a penalty marker down. We're going to have to see who this is on. Officials conferring at the 20-yard line. Penalty was at the 20. Personal foul on Dayton. Another dumb penalty. All these personal fouls are costing the Silverbacks. And it's going to be brought back to the 11 or to the 10-yard line of Dayton. So the Dayton Silverbacks will have it first and 10. They're just shooting themselves in the foot by these stupid penalties. Bryant out wide to the right or left. And we have an official timeout on the field, a media timeout, and we're going to take a timeout. With 8:54 to go here in the fourth quarter, Marion leads it 25-14 over the Silverbacks. We'll be right back with a final 8:54. You're listening to Silverback football on WolfCountry101.com and DATV.
All our licenses here. We've got four contestants for our next game, minute to minute. Here, what we're going to do is these four contestants, on the count of three, are going to pull all the tissue out of the box with one hand only. All right, they got 60 seconds to do so. We've got some great prizes for them. So whenever you're ready, here we go. On the count of three, remember, one hand alone. Here we go. Three, two, one.
back here at Hara Arena, 8:54 to go here in quarter number four. Our next home game here at Hara Arena will be May the 7th when the Indianapolis Enforcers come calling once again. The Enforcers, not a very good team, unfortunately. They're up in Chicago right now playing the Chicago Knights. And we are back to action here in Dayton. I formation. Pass intended for Bryant, goes way over his head, and it's incomplete. And we need a few more catches. So it'll be second down and 10 from the 10-yard line of Dayton with 8:37 to go. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in tonight to Dayton Silverbacks football on WolfCountry101.com and DATV. Glad you can join us. Next time, come on out here and check the action out in person. Two wide receivers, one to each side, high formation. Hand off to the I back. He's to the 15, to the 20, down to, up to the 23. That was Tolbert on the carry. And that's going to be a first down for Victor Tolbert and the Silverbacks at the Dayton 22-yard line. A hurry-up offense. We have Cromartie out wide to the right and Bryant wide to the left. I formation with Tolbert in the eye. Quick pass to Bryant, goes into the penalty box. And we have a Silverback down. That's Cromartie on the far side. And he is hobbling just a little bit. So we need another wide receiver out there. And that's going to send out, they're going to send out Vittorio Jones. Or make that Victor Tolbert. Tolbert out wide to the left. Two wide receivers to the right. Pass is complete to Bryant. He's down to the 15, down to the 16-yard line. And that's good enough for a first down for the Silverbacks. And they got to hurry it up. 6:50 to go here in the fourth quarter. So hurry up offense for the Silverbacks. Two wide receivers out to the far side. Cromartie and, Bryant's one of them. I can't see who the other number is. Tolbert out wide to the left here on the near side. Stanford in the shotgun. Stanford back to pass. Pass is picked off by Bryson Lawrence. And it's going to be first and 10 for the Marion Blue Racers with 6:13 and counting. That may do it for tonight. A good contingent of Marion Blue Racer fans in section 21 right across from us. And it'll be first and 10 for the Blue Racers at the 14-yard line of Marion. Turnovers and penalties have killed the Dayton Silverbacks tonight. In the last three games, they are averaging just 14 points a game, and that's not good offense right there. Three wide receivers out to the left side. Tatum in motion. Bad snap by Harris. Harris throws it away and into the seats right behind the penalty box. And a guy in a blue shirt has a souvenir to take home with 5:11 to go and the clock running. Section 26 is where it went. Make that section 24. Clock running with under 5 minutes to go now. Second down and 10 for the Blue Racers. Two wide receivers out to the right side. Williams and Tatum out wide to the left. Robinson wide to the right, and he goes into motion. Harris hands off to Haywood. Haywood breaks away to the 15, to the 20, and knocked out of bounds by Marcus Fales, and it looks like Haywood is down. Haywood hobbling off the field. He's going to be, they're going to send in Antonio Wells.
I think it might be skyline time.
So 4:14 to go here in the fourth quarter. Third down and four at the 19-yard line, or the 21-yard line of Marion. They got to get to the 25 or the 24. Two wide receivers to the near side. Pitch back to Wells. Wells gets close to the first down. We'll see how they mark it. Stop there by. Have to see what number that is. It's Stewart made the stop, so it's a first down. Just barely made the first down. It'd be first. Timeout Dayton with 3:32 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Right now, the Silverbacks will fall to 1-4. The Blue Racers will stay in the race and go to 4-1. Next week, the Silverbacks are off before they travel to Chicago to take on the Chicago Knights. The Knights have only played two games. Tonight was their third game, and it was a home game against the Indianapolis Enforcers, a team that the Dayton Silverbacks manhandled here in the opening game, their only win of the season. And they will be back here May the 7th, followed by Marion and then Chicago. Fort Huron has to come to town too. So it's 3:36 to go here in the fourth quarter. We have a timeout on the field called by Dayton. And it's not looking very good for the good guys, as Hawk Harrelson would say. So coaching, a revolving door in coaching over in Marion. This is their third head coach in three games. So here we go. Tatum out wide to the left. Wells wide to the right. I formation. Handoff, or fake handoff to. And we have a pass interference in the end zone. Pass interference against Dayton in the end zone. They did not turn around and look for the ball. They just blocked. So it's going to be first and goal for the Blue Racers at the one. That's the story of the season for the Dayton Silverbacks. So it'll be first and goal at the 1 yard line for the Marion Blue Racers with 3:26 to go in the fourth quarter. They're going to mark it at the 4 yard line. They're going to mark it at the 4, so it'll be first and goal, and we have another timeout. We're going to take a timeout. Timeout by Dayton. They're going to take a 30 second timeout. No, we're not. We're going to stay right here. So they're trying to figure out if it's a spot foul or not. I'd like to remind everybody that on May the 7th, when the Indianapolis Enforcers come to town, it will be Trotwood night. And the kickoff is at 7:30 here at Hara Arena. So right now, referee Les Anderson called the spot foul, or called the foul or penalty, and it's going to be first and goal for the Marion Blue Racers at the Dayton 4 yard line. First and goal, 3:25 to go. And the handoff to Hayward. We got a penalty marker down at the 7 yard line. It looks like in the holding area, and it is. Holding against the Dayton, or holding against Marion. Penalties have killed the Dayton Silverbacks so far tonight. trying to see how many penalties there were. Dayton has been whistled for 8 penalties so far. Clock running, 3:17 to go here in the fourth quarter. First and goal at the 9. Robinson goes in motion to the far side. Harris keeps it, goes up the middle. He's to the 5 and into the end zone for a touchdown.
Josh Harris, touchdown.
That, my friends, ices this one. Coach Lorenzo Stiles is not happy at all. Harris had a wide open middle of the field. It was the hole was so wide, I couldn't have gotten through it, and I'm a big guy, and I'm slow, too. So, Tyler Lorenz to kick the extra point. 31-14 is our score. Crowd leaving Hara Arena disappointed in the Silverbacks. Kick is up and hits the goalpost. And you can't advance that. So with 2:17 remaining here in the fourth quarter, the Silverbacks trail Marion 31-14. So we're going to take a... I thought we were going to take a quick timeout, but we only have a minute 17 left here till the 1 minute warning, so we're just going to keep it right here. But I'd like to remind everybody. A big announcement here. On May the 13th. On May the 13th here at Hara Arena, big announcement, Carl Edwards, NASCAR driver, the car number 99, the Aflac car, will be here at Hara Arena, so you got to get your tickets early for that one, because we'll have a big crowd for that one. May the 13th, we will play the Chicago Knights right here at Hara Arena, and our special guest will be Mr. Carl Edwards, and hopefully we'll get a chance to talk to Mr. Edwards when he gets up here to Hara Arena, so get your tickets early. Call the Hara Arena box office at 278-4776. End over kick coming down to the, hits the back wall, picked up by, he hit his head hard. Tolbert on the carry. He got hit hard. And it's gonna be first and 10 for the Silverbacks at their own 13-yard line with under 2 minutes to go here in this one. Disappointing night for the Silverbacks. They thought they could beat this Racer team. They've been playing fairly well. I mean, they've only scored 13, 14, and 15 points in the last 3 games, but the games have all been close. The defense has been tight, but the offense needs a little work. So here we go. 2 wide receivers out to the right side, 1 to the left. Stanford under center. Hand off to Marshall. Marshall to the 20, up to the 23-yard line. Stop by Best. And it'll be first down for the Silverbacks with 1:14 to go. Silverbacks lined up, Marshall in the eye, Stanford under center, gets it, and he's going to be sacked back at the 11-yard line. No offense, no blocking on the front line, and Coach Shepard is very, very hot on this one. So with 1 minute to go, we're at the 1 minute warning. We're going to take a timeout. You're listening to Silverback Football on WolfCountry101.com and watching it on DATV here in Dayton.
Thank you.
1 minute to go here in the game here at Hara Arena. The Silverbacks trail 31-14. And it's going to be a long 2 weeks before they hop on the bus and head to Chicago to take on the Chicago Knights. After that, it's a trip to Cincinnati, where you can join us. We're going to have the final minute of play right here at Hara Arena. You can join us April the 29th at Cincinnati Gardens with the Commandos and the Silverbacks. Man in motion, Stanford back to pass, fires downfield. Pass is going to be almost intercepted. Goes right between the guy's hands. Brian Williams, it went right through his hands. .8 seconds left in this one. Second down and a country mile. Ball resting at the 14-yard line, and they got to get to the Marion 17 for a first down. So here we go, trailing by 17. Stanford under center. Hand off to Marshall. Marshall down at the 15-yard line. No hurry for the Silverbacks. They're in no panic mode right now. So they've pretty much conceded this one. 30 seconds remain. It's fourth down. And they are going to go for it. Marion fans on their feet. Dayton fans leaving, heading out of the exits. And Dayton's just going to let this run out. We have a timeout by Dayton. Well, it's going to be a triumphant ride back to Marion. And the first win for Ryan Terry of the Marion Blue Racers. They will move to 4-1. Stay one game behind the Cincinnati Commandos. And the Silverbacks will fall to 1-4. With a trip to Chicago. Chicago's only played two games. They were 1-1 going into the game tonight. They should be 2-1 after tonight. And we didn't figure Chicago would be that tough, but they are. And it might be a tough contest for the Silverbacks when they go to Chicago in 2 weeks. We will be on the air at, we'll have to check out. I think it's 5:20 or 5 o'clock we'll be on the air. So 5.7 seconds left. Man in motion. Stanford back to pass. Goes to his right. He's going to run with it. He's got a lot of room. He's to the 20. He's to the 15, and that is that. For those of you watching on DATV, that is it. Thank you for watching. And for those of you on Wolf Country 101, we'll be right back. Thanks for watching on DATV.